Well, hello. It's time for the visit with the person of high strangeness. About a year and a half ago, we did a show with a young lady. Her name was, and still is actually, Gyan. And we got a real overwhelming response for that show. So in the meantime, I have traveled across the country twice. And what I found, even though I thought that the Vietnam era was something that us as Americans didn't really want to talk about, and I was just amazed and so proud of America as a whole, because everywhere I went, they asked about Gyan and wanted to know how she was, and we're going to give you a little update later how her health has changed in the meantime. And so what happens is today is the day that we're going to accommodate all the friends that wanted to get an update on Gyan and see how far she came in her evolution. And again, I thank everybody for having shown so much kindness to her and for the overwhelming response that we've been getting for this. And in the meantime, I have a voice that's coming back at me. I don't know if that's part of the show or if that's just one of those things that we do occasionally. So in the meantime, I would like now to introduce you to Gyan again. Hi, Gyan. How are you?
Fine. I'm fine right now, and hopefully that, you know, I'm back here again.
You are.
Between two different worlds, so I don't know if this is going to come up for us, for me.
It's going to come up. You know, we're going to both speak very slow because of our heavy accents, and occasionally we do shows with interpreters, but we did so well the last time that we didn't need an interpreter.
Yeah.
So I'm going to ask you a bunch of questions today.
Right.
You had phone calls? Friends called you?
Yeah, I did, and didn't come through. Eventually, when the things what I thought about, but it came out different, so I couldn't do it.
Well, one of the things that I believe we need to go there, the first time we visited here, we told the friends that there was a problem with Agent Orange.
Yeah, I thought about that, but it wasn't actually Agent Orange, I think something else. So.
Right. So
I'm just cancel that, yeah.
Yeah, so we need to correct that, because in the meantime you have been to the doctor a few times.
Yeah, and lots of doctors.
Lots of doctors, and they found that that's probably not what it was. But we're getting right along. I'd like to refresh the friends' memories. You are originally from?
I'm from Vietnam, Southeast Asia, and since I was a little girl. So I don't have any family, mom, dad. I just continue to live alone by myself, and that's a hard.
It was hard, yeah.
And very hard.
We told the friends that you had, at the age of 12, you went to work.
Yeah, I went to work to for Air Force Marine, a nurse state, and during the war. It began before Vietnam War.
And then eventually you were brought to America?
Yeah, and they met someone that brought me back, and brought me to the United States.
And then you lived in California, and
yes.
Let's talk about the movies that.
I lived in California, but then we got married there, and so we find out that my ex-husband's brother lived here, so we find the property, we bought it, and after that we didn't quite get along together, and so we just split up.
This is America.
Yeah.
Getting a divorce is very much in fashion, unfortunately. So in the meantime, you went to, you was in the process of putting a portfolio together?
Yeah, I would like to get back into that. I want, someday, I like to look forward to get back to making commercial. Yeah, I would love to do that.
Yeah, so that's something that maybe we can help with this time. And I understand that your children were so proud of you that you did that show.
I think it's pretty much excuse my story. But I hopefully, I don't know, in the future, my children, my children, maybe my
grandchildren
mm-hmm. would like to expect from me, and they like to expect from me what might come from.
Where you come from?
Yeah.
When we visit, and we are we are neighbors, and so sometimes we talk about our families, and the name of the show is Between Two Worlds, because
yes.
we sort of stuck between these cultures, so we talk quite often. And what I asked you the other day was that, and we can refresh the friend's memories, where you came from. You was actually a princess.
Yeah, I was a princess when I was 12 years old.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I'm here to tell everybody to believe
mm-hmm.
me. I mean, to understand where I might come from.
Mm-hmm.
Like everybody told me, United States, the children has to go to school.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing compare what I came from.
Mm-hmm.
We had to take a lot of responsibility.
I'm not sure, but I think we just lost our audio. Did we lose our audio? No? Okay. Anyway, so let me get back to what I was asking you. We were talking about your grandchildren. So what happened is that the question I had put to you at that time was, now that you have openly come forward, what do your grandchildren, are you going to teach them the olden ways?
I hopefully, if they are willing to listen,
mm-hmm.
yeah, if they're willing to listen, accept what I came from.
Mm-hmm. Well, like when we first come to the United States, we try so hard being American
mm-hmm.
that our children, we miss explaining things to them and telling them. Did
yeah.
you do that too?
Yeah, I try to explain to my daughter
mm-hmm.
and she understand.
Mm-hmm.
She like to learn about it,
mm-hmm.
but she's always a busy girl.
Yeah, we do live in really, really different
mm-hmm.
times. Now, you coming forward and having this new intimate relationship, you know, with people as a whole, has that make a difference in your life?
Never have. I mean, you know, all this still being the same way as I, you know, mm-hmm. came here, still be on my own
mm-hmm.
all the time. I need meet somebody that who responsibility and outgoing
mm-hmm.
and teach me, come and teach me, make me understand what the American way.
Mm-hmm.
The way that we go to work hard, the wage is not
mm-hmm.
there for me. It's not there.
When after we did that first show, several people called you with job offers, if you remember.
Yeah, and those things that scares me, because they might send you to way out, to rainier country, someplace.
To the rainier country.
Telling people, say, what am I at? You know, maybe I don't get in trouble. Who knows? It just scares me.
Yeah, so this is a really good time to explain something to the American friends.
Mm-hmm.
Because of the background
yeah.
and the different cultural background in languages, sometimes it is hard to learn things. And so we do well with hands-on, like, you know, you show us
yeah.
something and we see it and then we remember it.
Yeah.
And then when the friends come and say, well, oh, I have a new job for you, sometimes we either not qualified or we're just
mm-hmm.
scared.
Yeah, it scares me when, you know,
mm-hmm.
I'm not qualified for something. A reason why sometimes that, you drive at night, or
oh, that's right, and you don't drive
rain.
At night.
Yeah, I
yeah.
cannot drive at night. That's why
mm-hmm.
I don't get job, and I never did. I never work at night.
Mm-hmm.
Just one, twice, something like that. But that's about it. I did.
What would you like your life to be like?
I think I would change.
Mm-hmm. How would you like to change it?
I think when I want to change to meeting people
mm-hmm.
that are responsible and. Be able to teach me the way they do it And mm-hmm. then I can change from there. I would say that I'd like to get some kind of product commercial, mm-hmm. not any that kind of type of work, mm-hmm. something like that.
So in order to for friends to comprehend it, we have to go back again for a minute. You was telling me that the way the law was set up where you came from, tell me what your main laws were.
Yeah. Well, at this point, I can't comprehend it because it's all difficult. Well, the place I came from is so difficult to explain. There's so many things that you don't have, you know.
Mm-hmm. Where I was going with this, your laws were very simple. You don't steal?
Yeah, no steal.
Right.
No steal, mm-hmm. no divorce. No, we don't
lie.
Angry, we don't lie. Mm-hmm. We're hardly angry.
So it's much easier to live by three or four principle laws.
Yeah.
Instead of, you know, having to understand this very complicated structure that we have here.
Mm-hmm. It really struck me because it's, I have to learn new things every day.
Every day.
Learn new thing and learning and seeing that people no respect, you know.
Respect is a big issue.
Yeah.
Give me your definition of respect.
Respect is being kind, like, where you are, you mm-hmm. know. People have to accept where you are. Mm-hmm. And not destroying the feeling.
Mm-hmm. I would think that includes non-judgmental.
Yeah. Respect for people. Example, have friend that really destroying your feeling. Mm-hmm. Things that you try to be nice to them, that's not there for you. That's not. They don't care. Mm-hmm. Even at work. Mm-hmm. At work, the same thing. People, they don't give you the respect. Mm-hmm. The same thing.
Well, and then what was interesting to me was, you know, how we always group people by country. What was interesting to me at the time is that there is a distinction between where you came from and Vietnam itself. So it's not even the same. Like mm-hmm. America, you have a different groups of people in the same country. And
yeah.
I thought it was interesting to me.
Mm-hmm. It's very interesting because I live a different culture, different type of clothes.
Type of clothes, type of work, type of weapon. I remember we were... You told us the first time they went to town and came back with pants. Remember that
yeah,
story?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. I just couldn't wear pants.
Mm-hmm.
Never see people wear pants in my life, so I just kind of like different culture.
Different culture. So now mm-hmm. you have two things to stick your legs in.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but yeah. Majority of people, it's really hard to understand mm-hmm. when you're not familiar with that. I have a story for you. When I had heard that in America, everything is in a can, you know? You can go to the store, everything is in a can.
Yeah.
And so I had a very demanding husband, you know. So one night I was mm-hmm. late doing something, so I thought, oh, I go to the store and I buy some food. So I buy this can, it had a chicken on it.
Mm.
And I got home. You know, but one of those little army.
Oh, yeah.
You know, the little army openers,
yeah,
they were
uh-huh.
so handy. Now, uh-huh. open it. Do you know what it was? Crisco.
Crisco?
It was Crisco.
Oh, Crisco oil.
Yeah.
But the first
shortening.
Time I saw, yeah.
Yeah, but it had the picture of a chicken on it.
Mm.
And of
oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, so my husband was not very happy.
Yeah.
Because it no dinner, you see.
Mm-hmm.
So when we first see these new things, we get all excited, but sometimes it's not even the same thing. I had asked you that at my house, and I told you I was going to ask you that.
Yeah.
So you had a couple of days to think about it. If you are in charge of the world, what are you going to do?
If I'm in charge of the world, just like I was doing when I was a princess.
Right.
You know, and mm-hmm. people hungry, mm-hmm. hungry, I help other people, but also I have to tell them, you know, go tell other people to do the way that we're doing. Mm-hmm. We, you know, keep them in charge.
Mm-hmm.
Some reason. Some things that you can do that. Some things mm-hmm. you just stay home.
Stay
home. Let them do anything what you tell, I think.
Mm-hmm.
But the rest, I don't know. I have no idea what my opinion.
It's not hard to be in. It's not easy being a princess, is it?
No, it's not easy. When, especially when my mom, my dad is the chief of the honor and third in the country, and they go point to me. Gyan had to mm-hmm. go sell what food for to feed these people.
Mm-hmm.
You know, go sell them. So I go sell them. I sell them. You know, I trade. And then mm-hmm. for some reason, I trade in for quality thing.
Mm-hmm.
So we give them a crop, and I trade them some kind of gold.
Mm-hmm. Now, we in the time period that we are here, we're not going to name names, but we are electing this new president. And I often think it must be hard to be a president.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Everybody wants you to do something different.
Mm-hmm.
One doesn't like your face, one doesn't like what you think, mm-hmm. one doesn't like how you get dressed. Do you think there is too much freedom in America?
Too much freedom? Some kind.
Sometimes, no?
Yeah, sometimes. Some kinds of freedom sometimes. I don't think that much freedom. It's still difficult when you don't can't find work, can't freedom.
It is, yeah.
People have lucky people that lucky to be able to went to school, graduate, mm-hmm. be college, and get a better job.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's they be able to go past freedom.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you see, because if you have the right to do one thing, and then I have the right to say, well, I don't like what you do, and let's make a new law. So mm-hmm. the more laws we add in America, the harder it's going to get for people, and more confusing for us, what do you think?
Mm-hmm. There's a lot of confusion. I've seen many debating right now. They don't know which one they choose. Everybody say, you vote for me.
Mm-hmm.
And then one another person, you vote for me. I don't know who mm-hmm. can vote for. And now they.
Yeah, America, I think, is the best country to live in. But we have sometimes too many choices, and then people take a lot of things for granted.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Now it's stressed me out. I've been stressed, and I've been upsetting because something that you really doing things differently and become better,
mm-hmm.
like they are. And they wouldn't sell you, you know, they wouldn't help you. And that mm-hmm. really engaged to me.
Mm-hmm. So basically, what do you need from people?
Basically, teach me.
Just to teach you?
Yeah, mm-hmm. teach me and show me the way. Mm-hmm. I've been baking there for a long time.
You've been here a long time?
Yeah, I've been baking about this long time. I need somebody mm-hmm. that good quality. Mm-hmm. And responsible, and come talk to me and teach mm-hmm. me. I can change a new life. You know, I want to be a new life. I can change, but my old life is not understanding mm-hmm. the English. So,
do you know what a mentor is?
Some, not too much.
I think a mentor is a person that takes someone under their wing, you know, where listens to people and teaches people.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think that it would be possible for you to become a mentor to some of the young children?
I wish, yeah.
We have a lot to teach them,
mm-hmm.
no?
Yeah, I wish. Maybe. Mm-hmm.
And you have grandchildren now?
I don't know, somewhere else. I think my grandchildren is in Silverdale. They live in Silverdale.
Oh, in Silverdale?
Mm-hmm. They move up there.
But you do have grandchildren?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I have two grandchildren. Mm-hmm. So they live long, far away. Her and I, we had lots of good time. Mm-hmm. She's so cute and beautiful. Mm-hmm. I'm so thankful for that.
So now I want to get back to your health here for a minute. Now that things are a little better for you, what are you experiencing emotionally?
Stress, upset.
A lot of stress
and upsetting. You know, because somehow that I meet people that don't respect, mm-hmm. and that's that put me down big time. But I'm better, you know.
You are better, yeah.
I'm good at things. Mm-hmm. I'm good at a lot of things. But mm-hmm. even I don't know about reading and write that much, but mm-hmm. I'm good at many things. Mm-hmm. I think it's still a miracle that I came here, a little girl.
Let's talk about that. You are mm-hmm. a miracle. Tell the friends what your name means again. Tell the friends again what your name means.
It means galaxy. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and universe and galaxy.
Yeah, so imagine being born with and if someone gives you a name like that, and that right there is like you need to hold the whole world on your shoulder. So even your name has a lot of responsibility.
Yeah, it's just like border of United States and China mm-hmm. and Vietnam, on the border of that. Mm-hmm. It's kind of different universe. A different universe, I think that's what I call. A galaxy, a different universe.
I don't understand that. Are we talking about borders, country borders?
Borders. Yeah, border like a line of the...
borders.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Now, a galaxy to me means galaxy with stars, and that's the same thing?
It's the same thing. Begin with like a border of United States and America and different countries, then
I see.
A universe is a star.
So we are talking about the same thing.
Mm-hmm. A star and people live in a space, you know, like that. That's where my name came from.
So you're a space person?
Mm-hmm.
In a way, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Well, you know, with all respect, that's what I mean. But what a wonderful name to have, to be the beginning of a galaxy.
Yeah, I think nowadays people can start name the children.
Wonderful.
Like my name, you know.
Your name. Yeah, actually is a beautiful name. And so in a way you are a miracle, you know, how you survived the things you came here.
Yeah, only things I try to live day by day, mm-hmm. you know, because I don't have family, only I have my children, my three children, and mm-hmm. I'm so glad I don't have no brother or sister. That's why I told you before, no mom, dad, mm-hmm. no besides mm-hmm. at that point right now. It's just really hard for me to teach my children, because I know I'm the parent, but to me right now, it's my children and I seem to like grow up together, you know.
Well, yeah, that's the other thing, that in America, and we do have teenage pregnancies mm-hmm. That people are not really that happy about, but in America, people usually try to pick their time to have their children. But in other countries, girls get married 11, 12.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So when we're 15 and don't have a husband, we're in trouble now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I think now they United States, there is law.
That's a law.
There's mm-hmm. law. There's cannot mm-hmm. marry when you're 13.
Right, but we were so young mm-hmm. when we got married, and that's why we grew up with our children.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what happened about my home mm-hmm. town. That everybody married so early mm-hmm. because there's no choice. You have no choice.
Are these arranged marriages?
No, and just people just point. When you're talking to people, you know, I saw a few of my girlfriend, they just point them, say, you're going to marry to this guy, you have no choice. You have to marry to this woman, you have no choice.
Does that work, though? You don't have a choice.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's never a divorce, you know. Mm-hmm. This, they give you that way, just stay that way. Mm-hmm. They have no choice.
That's hard. So suppose, and I mean, we are all... all set up emotionally the same, supposing you are married to someone mm-hmm. that you had no choice and then you fall in love with someone else, what are the consequences?
There's no, besides that, you cannot fall in love with nobody. You have only one choice, the way they give you.
But what if you do?
Just no attract. I think that's where my home, I heard, I seen, you know.
You seen it? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I seen it. Like my sister, they married, mm-hmm. when they married that guy, people just married to them. Mm-hmm. And that's it.
Okay, I understand that part. But let's say then after a while, you fall in love with somebody else after you're married. What are mm-hmm. the consequences? What trouble can you get into?
Oh, they, there's a lot of fight for. People hope you fight for that over there because they have to be honest. Married for one. You know, for one person, they have to be really kind of like jealous whenever mm-hmm. somehow if get jealous, everybody have to gather outside to be fight for.
Oh, a duel?
Yeah.
Oh.
People gather together and let's go fight like that. And that let people learn not to do that again. One day, when I saw when I was a little girl, people from the village, everybody screaming, you know. Everybody screaming, let's come together, let's mm-hmm. fight. Mm. That was terrible. they do that.
But over there. It's easier to put people in prison and everything.
No prison in my
no
village.
Prison.
No prison. People get a fight in the front of people's eye, and that's it.
We should
people
try
learn.
That. We should.
I think this
have people come
try.
And duke it out. Mm-hmm.
Well, that's gonna be hurt, though.
Well, you but know? By principle, you know, that could
oh,
work.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. By principle, and over here, I have to go to court. We don't go on hearing other people.
Well, no, but here we're talking about different laws here. So if you understand, if there's a problem, I'm going to have to fight this person. That is your mm-hmm. consequence.
Yeah.
And then here, when we do something a little different, then we know we have to go to court.
Yeah.
Those are the consequences. Mm-hmm. But I would think to fight someone get it over with would be easier than to have to go to prison for 20 years.
Oh, yeah, definitely. That's what I talked to a friend of mine and said, you cannot touch me because if you do, you're going to go to jail. And mm-hmm. I hope that he, you know, I think he's scared. Mm-hmm. You know, I think that's why they left. I think they're scared.
Yeah, but you see, in America, we have over 2 million laws. So we have a law for everything. Mm-hmm. So if we only had the three, like you said, no lying,
yeah,
no stealing, and what was the third one?
No lying, no stealing, no just basic two, three of those things, and
It's so much easier to remember just those, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. And but here again, the name of the show is Between Two Cultures. We're just kicking around here how we're sort of stuck in the middle here. Mm-hmm. We look at it this way and we look at it that way. Mm-hmm. Because we do have some choices. What is next for you?
My future, next for me. I can't pronounce what I need to do. I just need to get a better job.
You need just a better job?
And better job.
But I understand you're going to have some surgery to help with your face. And
I'm going to do that as soon as possible. I just hang on it right now. That's what I thought I would be waiting. We can do this all next time until I get better, but...
Oh, we'll do another one and see how it came out, yeah.
Yeah, and this one just kind of hard for me to talk, so that's why.
Yeah, we had some technical difficulties here today, so Gyan is having problems talking, so I said I would do the majority of talking, that's why.
Yeah.
We got it laid out like that. But it is so hard to get you in the studio because you always work, you know.
Yeah, I always work so hard, 6 days a week. Didn't make the show for it, but I try.
Yeah, so we've tried to do that, what for?
I
for
told
7, 8 months?
I told everybody, a friend of mine, I say I'm a hard worker.
You are?
I come home, I cook and cleaning, picked up after them, you know, but and they still not really respect me. That's hurt.
I think your main issue is the word respect. But respect is just so many different things to different people.
Yeah. They don't polite. They don't care. Yeah. And I would like to have somebody that care for how you are. Love for who you are. The way that they treat you so good. You know, things like that.
And I know that sometimes when one of us doesn't feel good in the neighborhood, you bring food and... We really appreciate that, you know, so you're always doing something else.
I always can do a lot more than that. Someday when I get better, I think I can do better.
Let's talk about getting better for a minute. Sometimes when we physically ill or we have a condition, we get so stressed because we use energy to concentrate on all the things we cannot do. And then we say, well, when I get better, I'm going to do this. And when I get better, I'm going to do that. When in reality, the energy is misguided, is misrouted. What we need, what we should do, actually, and should is just a word here, you know, maybe we have choices, but if we take that energy and concentrate on getting better, and saying, well, I'm going to direct this energy towards myself to get better. And when I am better, then I'm going to do such and such a thing.
Yeah, and more. Mm-hmm. You can do a lot more. Because I'm still strong, and my physical is strong. And it's one thing I need to get healed. But I'm strong. I can still love faster. I can I do fast work. And some people, they say, well, not only you, Pastor, some other people, and that's not respect either.
Yeah, it just takes such a such an effort to change your line of thinking, you know?
Yeah. So to me, I think I can do lots of good. If somebody get to know me more, get to spend time and talk to me and help me out. Right now, I need the heal voice number one. When I get this heal, I think I need somebody to come and talk to me and lead me direction, what kind of job next future I need to have.
Now, I don't know if you're willing to talk about this, but I just remembered something. A lot of people feel that we create our own problems, you know, and I get very upset with this because I don't think we do create our own problems, because there are some things that is just how it is. Now, many months ago, you told me that in your culture and who you are, if you get sick, you can just leave your body mm-hmm. and then come back and you're well, right?
Yeah, and it's two different things. When you're sick, you're sick. But sometimes when you somehow, I don't know, people are different than me, because one of each year, I haven't been down there for since 1994, mm-hmm. 94, when I can't just sleep for 3 days and I come back. And then I just go visit somebody in the universe.
In the universe, astral projection.
Yeah.
Now, you know, the last time I talked about that subject with a friend, she was talking about that. And she, in her mind, you know, she just kept leaving. So I knew that. And so when I came, I thought I had to leave a little bit with her. And I broke my leg, because when I came back, my body wasn't all there. Now, So the friends, the reason I'm telling you that again, and about the 10th time, I believe, but my broken leg story, because we as people, we really have the capability of doing this. Just putting yourself in suspension.
Yeah.
Is that another word?
I have been 2 times in my life mm-hmm. that kind of like conscious, and mm-hmm. you're gone for 3 days, mm-hmm. and you come back. And I don't know how I get back. I don't know mm-hmm. how I came back. Kind of conscious, but I still came back on my own. Mm-hmm.
Now, my question is, in theory, this should work, you see. In theory, if you're able to do that, if you could just leave for 2 or 3 days and come back, and you could be totally healthy, could you do that?
I can be, because I almost lost. I didn't even know what I'm at. Now, when mm-hmm. I came out that morning, mm-hmm. I said, Emma, where am I? You know, I just keep knocking everybody. Where am I? I supposed to be in Ventura.
She in said, Ventura?
That, yeah. Mm-hmm. She said, yeah, you are Ventura. I said, don't look like. Where's my room? And I was outside. I woke up from the door, and I didn't even know where my room's at.
That's what we call crash landing, mm-hmm. when you come back into your body and then you get disoriented and go in circles round and around mm-hmm. and until you get grounded, where you get some sort of a perspective where you are, because you don't recognize people. You
yeah.
don't recognize
Yeah, I don't places. Recognize mm-hmm. city. And I walk outside and look, and it was the mountain, Ventura Mountain. Mm-hmm. You know, and afterward I find her upstairs, and I said, I need my manager, the mm-hmm. apartment manager, and she took me to the doctor mm-hmm. because she would get scared, because I was passed out for three days.
3 days, yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, from what I understand is when we go into suspended episodes here, we shouldn't wake the people up or touch them, because it can kind of scare you, and then you really crash land. Now, for the friends that's allergic to I can't say that work. Somebody help me, please. When you have surgery and they put you to sleep. No, not antiseptics. The other one. Anesthetic. Close enough? Mm-hmm. And so what happens is, it's very hard. Sometimes people have to take out stitches or do something like that, mm-hmm. and then it's painful, but when mm-hmm. you have the capability of doing this, mm-hmm. you can just leave. And yeah. then when it's all finished, you come back. Mm-hmm. You see, just like that.
Yeah.
And so since we're talking about this, what is preventing you from leaving and coming back in your faces?
I have no idea. I just automatically, it does, mm-hmm. 3 times. Sometimes people, I don't know how many people, see people over the dead and like a ghost. Mm-hmm. Yeah, at work, a bridge, her name's Kay. Mm-hmm. She died years ago. Mm-hmm. And I was cleaning the house, cleaning the office there, nobody's mm-hmm. around. I saw her just walk through the wall. Mm-hmm. And I said, you know, I'm scared to go clean its office, right? Mm-hmm. And I do it anyway, by myself. And she just walked right through me and just disappeared through the wall.
She walked through you too?
Mm-hmm, towards mm-hmm. me, just about from there to there. Mm-hmm. And just, I was just cleaning, and mm-hmm. I said, who was that, you know? I followed her, I tried to follow her. I thought that's just not mm-hmm. her, but it's her. She walked through the wall, I thought that was a door, and it's no door.
Yeah.
She just walked through the wall.
Yeah, I was talking to a lady yesterday. I gave a lecture at a psychic fair and did some readings, and there was a lady from Squim. That's a little town up in, almost at the tip of Washington State, for the friends that don't live here. And it's just a little town. Anyway, this lady, she had came in an RV, and mm-hmm. her and her daughter, and she was selling things and doing readings and things. And she said that wasn't too long ago, she slipped and fell, and she dropped almost 25 feet. Now, that's very high. Mm-hmm. And on her way down, she said, like, I'm coming this way at 20 miles an hour, she says, and then I saw something, and I grabbed it, and I hung onto it, and it stopped mm-hmm. my fall. But guess what? There was nothing there. She thought it was solid for her, but the people that saw her fall, she mm-hmm. was just hanging there. Mm-hmm. So there are unseen things that are physical mm-hmm. in that state in that state that we're in at that time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. The first thing that I saw ghost is before my long time when I was a little girl, I was lonely. And my sister and I, my brother, we stay in a field, the house field. I saw my mother is walk from the mountain, and she walked across the river's a big, mm-hmm. and then the Nesqually River, like the river big, like Columbia River. Mm-hmm. She just like that. We had rivers like that, and she just walked through it.
Just walked through it.
And I didn't. After that, when my mother has passed away, I keep thinking, I think that's her ghost. Mm-hmm. I think that's her ghost, you know, otherwise, who can it be, mm-hmm. you know, walking through the water like that.
So, originally, you honor your ancestors?
I have no idea.
You don't, yeah. Now, where I come from, we are now ancestors, and I know a lot of people in the Middle East and in South, can say that, Southeast Asia, you know, acknowledge and honor the ancestors. And I think that's a wonderful way to do that, because we are an extension. If it was not for them, we wouldn't be here. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think so. I don't know, maybe I think that God was give it to me some kind of a special
gift
that mm-hmm. That's why, because nobody came to United States, like try so hard mm-hmm. and finally met somebody that be able to help you mm-hmm. to bring you over here, because I planned to go. To come over here when I was a little girl, like 6 years old.
I kind of knew I was coming here too, mm-hmm. and it doesn't really make any difference where we are born. Mm-hmm. Some things that happen to us in our life, they are is predestined, you know, mm-hmm. and sometimes it's under very horrible circumstances. You know, do we get from this place to another place? It's like rocks. I never thought too much about rocks, and then one of my guests said that sometimes she bends down and picks up a rock, uh-huh. and then she takes it, gets on an airplane, and gives it to someone there. Now, many years ago, we could track people and tribes and customs just by the dishes and the rocks that were in that area, mm-hmm. but we can't do that anymore, because you know, you can give me something and I fly across country and I give it to the next person.
Uh-huh.
You see, so I think the way life is set up, we're going to end up where we should be, even though if we wasn't born there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What do you think? You think that you will be continue up to a certain time that you know how long you live? Are you be still continue after that? We extend it your life.
You mean,
does anybody believe that?
Well, I do. I believe life continues. You go from one form to another.
Uh-huh.
I believe that. And I think some people have many lifetimes, mm-hmm. you know, on this earth or not. Myself, I remember no life before this one.
Yeah.
But then maybe I have amnesia.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I think, you know, right now, of course, you and I are lonely.
Mm-hmm.
After your children moving away, mm-hmm. and nobody's there for you.
Yeah.
Really, that's really lonely, isn't it? But I depend on somebody up there that can guide me through it,
mm-hmm.
to live we extend. So
on this life after death, and you would you happen to know if you had been born before?
Do I know?
Did I
have been born before?
Mm-hmm.
No, I think I probably born a different person.
That's what I'm asking.
Each year, you know, like
each lifetime, you are a different person.
Like the one I pass out for 3 days, and you were born again.
Oh, you came back as another person.
Yeah, another person.
That's different. That's a different concept.
Mm-hmm.
That's great. If you can just take a break and. Do you have the memory of the person before you?
No. You, before me, it's some of them I will remember like when I was a child.
Mm-hmm.
But between those,
nothing.
I don't know where I've been. You know, I don't know what I've been through.
I've talked to friends where we talked about walk-ins. In fact, we did a whole show. A walk-in is a person that... the soul or the essence makes an agreement with another being,
mm-hmm.
and then one person leaves. I'm not sure where they go, but I'm sure they are rewarded or
mm-hmm.
they get payment of some sort for this, and they vacate the body so the next person can come in.
Mm-hmm.
That is called a walk-in.
Yeah, mm-hmm. or something like that. Yeah.
Something like that. You see, in reincarnation, most of the time, people are reborn, like they are born again to a human mother. But mm-hmm. a walk-in, they just come in, all finished. Mm-hmm. They can be people from the universe, from the galaxy, and they just walk right in.
Mm-hmm.
Is that what you mean?
Yeah, because a long time ago, I had saw my picture.
Mm-hmm.
And if I live the same person, I still look like that. That's why I had a different look. It's mm-hmm. naturally, because mm-hmm. I think that's why I have different person. Because it's, you know, different look,
mm-hmm.
It will be different person.
Okay, so let's say you have some memories of the person you was before, but then you bring back new memories,
mm-hmm.
new knowledge when you come back.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You should write that down.
Because before then, I hardly speak English.
Mm-hmm.
Hardly. After my new me.
Mm-hmm.
And I can speak English. I can talk myself. I can speak Vietnamese. I heard Vietnamese. I speak Vietnamese immediately. I speak Spanish. I ask Spanish and I keep in my head. I can speak
just
immediately.
Knew it, yeah.
It just knew right then.
Oh, that's an interesting spin on our show here. Oh, my. If you could, you should start writing down some of these things. This is really fascinating.
Yeah, that's what I need to hear first. My mind
mm-hmm.
can, so I can read because my eyes mm-hmm. setting right now because my teeth problem.
It's really hard when you can't see. Like I said, I was gone this weekend, and a young lady came, and I wear trifocals, you know, one, two, three, like that. And I said to the woman, I said, "Oh, what a nice kitty you have." And she said, "What kitty?" And I said, "The kitty." But you know what it was?
What?
It was a paper sack. It was a kitty.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
that's
I did.
Pretty good.
I
yeah.
thought it was a kitty. But, you know, when your eyes don't work, then we just...
Yeah. I think that's... what I wanted to say, and that's so important for me to say on TV because I think that is giving me a miracle that I have been reformed a new person. So,
yeah, people were really excited, you know, just knowing that there was a possibility for you that you come back and do another show because they really took well to you. And again, they did so appreciate you coming forward because they said it was. They was very rare for a person in your, with your background to come and, and talk about these things, especially in the Midwest. Have you ever been in the middle part of the country, Illinois, Miami, and?
I've been in Illinois, Michigan for almost 5 years.
I noticed you look up. Are you sensing anything? Because sometimes when we tape these shows. Sometimes there is a presence, sometimes we have ghosts, sometimes we have noises. Are you getting anything?
Well, in my senses, it's just, my senses, I just like to finding a way inside me.
Oh, you wanna...
I wish that I can be the psychic, you know.
Well, again.
See, I had sense of people. That's why I don't make too many friends, you know.
Yeah, well, I'm noticing you're doing something. That's why I said, you know, so why do you wish you were a psychic? You probably know a lot of things. So just explore that and, you know, and go with that.
It just seems that somehow, like, people who I really want to talk to, and that's people I choose. And... like you, the person that I met you, and that person that we make choice, I choose the comfortable to talk to. I don't just go around the neighborhood and talk to all the neighbors.
Oh, I know.
Because I sense that person that can be good for me.
We've done a few fun things together, you know. But give yourself credit. It's I was observing you. I know you saw something, so that's why I said, you know.
So something,
So maybe it's another miracle, and you have another new gift, and you need to use it because there are no coincidences. Ah, it's been a sort of an interesting show. We was going to talk about practical things, and we got real spiritual. That was wonderful. Now, would you believe we were here almost an hour, and you thought you couldn't do an hour?
That's pretty good,
It was pretty good because time goes very fast when we're visiting with the friends.
Yeah, I think for these people, they help us out.
It's wonderful. Thank you. That's true. Let's thank the staff. And and you fixed lunch today, so we have to thank you too. And our staff is here at all time. And so I guess you come and visit us again, and we... going to see you next week with another unusual story. We'll see you next week. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.